To the denizens of a politically correct world, being candid is not much of a preference. But in an age where the youth defines the society, where the youth believes in openness, frankness, we have come up with a show known as the Candid Gardenian, where we believe the gardenians should not hold themselves back and speak what's on their mind. Good evening, my name is Riniki Sanyal, and today I have someone with me who terms himself as Bindas, someone who's happy-go-lucky, and someone who intriguingly can ape a crow very well. Welcome to the show, Rahul.
Hello, Dee.
Okay. Can you quickly ape the voice of a crow?
Yeah, sure. Okay.
All right, you guys must have heard that. He's quite interesting as a person. Could you tell me, Rahul, how does it feel being a part of the show? You're the first person we are interviewing.
It's awesome. I had thought that I'll be the first candidate of this show. It's a first experience for me to being interviewed by someone, and it's really awesome to be here.
All right. Where are you from?
I'm from Jharkhand, Bokaro.
All right. And why did you choose Garden City for your graduation?
Because when I visited Bangalore, I heard about this Garden City College, and when I came here, I found a very good environment, very good teachers. I interacted with the receptionist and all. They were too nice for me, and they just told me the facilities, the infrastructure which the college is providing to us is too good. So I just decided to join the college.
Okay, and how has it been for you as a fresher? How was it being a part of fresherism?
It was really awesome experience for me. Means it was first time for me to experience all these kind of things. They just said me to sing, dance, ramp walk. Ramp walk means first time in my life I do ramp walk over here, and I found myself quite good in that. And they just said me to write some articles and all. Means they give such good opportunity to show how much talent you have inside yourself.
All right. So if you had to describe fresherism in one sentence, what would it be?
Awesome.
What do you think is the best feature of Garden City?
Best feature of Garden City, to be very much supportive for you. Whatever good thing you want to do for yourself and for your future, Garden City will do a lot for you.
3 years down the line, when you graduate from this college, what do you think you're going to take back with you?
Sweet, good memories, awesome experience, love of teachers, respect of our seniors. Love in my heart.
All right, Rahul. It's been an absolute pleasure having you on the show. Emphasis is alive. Welcome to yet another episode of The Candid Gardenian. When we talk of Freudian philosophies, interpretation of dreams, when we talk of what goes on in the human mind, is it not interesting enough, psychology as a word, as a subject of study? Well, here I have someone with me today who's very interested in pursuing psychology. Can you quickly tell me something about your childhood?
I was born and brought up in Saudi Arabia. I'm originally from Kerala.
Why did you take up journalism, psychology and English as your subject of study for graduation?
The main aim was actually psychology, and you know, when you go for the best colleges, this was actually the combination that came in. And psychology, I wanted to pursue in cognitive psychology, so that's why I came for psychology. The combination is just like, you know, just gets complete with journalism and the English together with it.
How does it feel being a part of Garden City College?
Obviously, the whole place is so beautiful. The campus is just so warming. It's just so good. You know, you always feel at home, you know, the campus, the hostel. Everything all together, I've never felt homesick, you know. Just once in a while when we get the call from our home, but otherwise it's just beautiful, you know. This is the place if you want to like concentrate on all activities as well as studies. I think Garden City is the best place to be.
Okay, how do you think the college can aid you in what you aim at?
I came to this college because it offers, you know, it's one of the best colleges in Bangalore, and it offers good courses. So just by giving me my certificate, if this Garden City College degree itself, it's a big thing. So, you know, that's how this college can help me. And in other ways, all the extracurricular activities, it brings up our character, it brings up our personality, and extracurricular activities are like a lot in Garden City, you know. If you have a talent, you know, you can't like hide it or anything. It has to come out if you're here.
What do you think you're going to take back with you?
I'm going to take back big degree from a big college. Other than that, I'm going to take like just having lots of memories from any other college. I think, you know, all the members here so far, just 2 months, you know, down the line, and we already had, you know, great friends, great memories already. You know, even though I wasn't a part of Fresherism, you know, the whole thing was great. And everything has changed in me. Like, you know, you get a lot of experience here, you know, with all the international students. That's one of the best part here. You know, I have a Chinese sitting beside me and an African sitting the other side. So it's lots of experience and lots of good memories.
And what do you have to say about the hostels?
It's just, I've stayed in a hostel before and I've always had problems. I had to go home every other week. But here I'm fine, you know, I don't even, you know, we just go home for the sake of going home. I'm like I said, it's, you know, it's totally at home. You don't feel like you're in some other place or you're in some other state or some other city. You're just going to be fine here. It's good.
Coming back to the subjects of study, what do you have to say about journalism?
Journalism, I was not a big fan of journalism before, but after coming here, we just have wonderful teachers. Really impressed me. One of the best I've seen in my whole life. You know, our teachers, they're like, you have to know everything to be a journalist, really. You can't just live a passive life and then be a journalist. So it's something that connects you to the world, you know, and all the wrong reports coming up and all that, you know, it's just so good. After choosing journalism, I've started reading more magazines, you know, on a critical basis and stuff. So it just gives you more knowledge. If you have knowledge, you can take journalism. You can't be like any other person and go for journalism. So, you know, it's a very interesting subject, really very interesting.
Thank you for being in the show. It's been an absolute pleasure. Emphasis is alive. We have Ms. Malvika Espabu with us. Welcome to the show. Malvika, you are in your second year of graduation. How does it feel being an amateur journalist in Garden City College?
Well, it's a very interesting experience to be to know about the basics of journalism in the course I am doing. And I have been getting a lot of exposure in this college because of the magazine as well as the daily newspaper. From the first year itself, I have started working for the newspaper as well as magazine as a reporter. And now I am very accustomed, as Viniki said, to taking the interviews of the Gardenians of the Gardenian of the Month in the magazine. I have taken up a column, and it's a very interesting experience to know about the real journalism. And I'm glad that I'm getting the experience in my college level itself.
All right, Malvika, what is this column all about, Gardenian of the Month?
It's about featuring a student, two students, a male and a female, one from the UG department and one from the PG department, who excels both in the academics and co-curricular activities simultaneously. A person who can divide his attention properly between both of them, we consider them to be very real gardenians, and that is what the column is all about. We feature about them, their childhood, their likes, their desires, how have they been in Garden City College, their academic qualifications, all these things.
You know, why this decision of coming down to Garden City for your graduation?
What happened was that my dad was thinking of the best colleges in India for journalism, and that is when one of his friends from Bangalore told, there's this college in Bangalore, Garden City College, which offers a very good combination of three subjects. It was the combination as well as the college. They told, in terms of exposure, it's the best college in India, and the tagline, emphasis is on life. That really captured my attention, and that was when we decided to come down to Bangalore, to Garden City College.
What do you think has been the turning point of your career here in GCC?
Undoubtedly, it would be the association with GCC World, the magazine, the monthly magazine in the college. When I came to the college, I found the magazine very nice. I was flipping through the pages, I saw very interesting stories, and I saw that very young students wrote about this. I became interested, and that was when I met the staff coordinator, Sir Patrick sir, who told that I can write stories and whatever you feel like, you can write about it. And now I am one of the correspondents of the magazine, and I have been working for the magazine for more than 1 year now.
How does it feel to work for the magazine? Is it taxing enough, or how do you balance it with your academics? Or, you know, what I would like to ask is that at this point, does it become a pressure on you, or you enjoy doing what you're doing with the magazine?
I enjoy doing what I do with the magazine, but sometimes it's a little pressurizing. Because when you have, I told that the Gardenian of the Month, we have to interview two people. But I don't find it very difficult to balance it with my studies.
Where have you been staying, Malvika, here?
I am staying in the hostel, the college hostel.
How's hostel life?
It is good. It's pretty good.
Thank you so much for being with us on the show. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Thank you. Emphasis is
life. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Candid Gardenian. Today, let's talk of something interesting, baby names. There's a lot of hullabaloo that goes about Indian baby names. The way the name should be, what it means, whether there's been anybody in the family who has had the same name. Isn't it very interesting to know how and why a baby is named so and so? Well, here I have somebody with me who was so cute as a child that her aunt had said, "We relish cuddling her." And that's how she got her name, Relisha. Welcome to the show, Relisha.
Hi, Runiki.
Hello. How did you get your name?
Well, that's quite long ago. I was a baby then, maybe less than a month old, and my aunt just looked at me and she said, "Oh wow, she looks so sweet." And the first word that comes to your mind when you say sweet is relish. So they said, let's add an A to the relish and make a name out of it. So that's how Relisha was born.
Okay, that's quite a unique name. Why did you choose Garden City for your post-graduation?
Well, to be honest, once my graduation was done, I realized I really needed a break from Mumbai. I was completely exhausted. I was completely fed up of, you know, running around behind the same old things without knowing what you want to do. I mean, I've been born and brought up there, and you know, the environment where it's all about competition, you have to be the best, and they keep pushing you and pushing you. And I realized I needed my space away from my peers, away from, you know, people who keep telling me, you know, do this and do that, this is good and this. Of course, they're right. But I realized some point of time I was losing what I really wanted to do. So that's the reason I was looking at my options. Bangalore seemed like the perfect city for me. I didn't want to be anywhere close to Pune because that would mean I have to come back on weekends. And I needed a big, nice place. And Bangalore was it. I searched online for good places for my PG. And Garden City happened to be one of those places which seemed most comfortable. When I looked at the campus online, I searched it online, I looked at the pictures, and it seemed like I knew I would feel at home here. I knew I would be able to explore my options here. So that's how Garden City happened, and I applied and things like that. And then I came here last month to check the campus. And I knew this was it. So I was away from home. I knew I had my space. I knew I could do whatever I wanted. So that's the reason this college.
What is it, you know, that you think that this college can offer you?
This college has a lot more to offer. For example, say the entrepreneurship cell. Not a lot of colleges have this. You know, somewhere you can just approach someone, and the best part is people are so much friendly, so you don't hesitate into telling them, okay, you might be wrong, you might be talking something absolutely absurd, but people will still hear you out. So I think that's a plus point, and so I wouldn't hesitate to go across and tell them, okay, look, I have so and so plan, and that is what I'm looking forward to the most. And it's got everything in it. It's got a blend of everything. Take for example the fresherism, and I saw the number of events that the UG students had, and I think it's something very brilliant. It molds people, and this college has that to offer. The very fact that the students are so much involved into things, the vibrance that they add to this place, I think that adds a lot to my personality as well. I get a lot to pick up from each and every one who's around, be it in the hostel, be it my classmates, or be it anyone who's working around the place, even for the sweeper for that matter, or the teachers are so brilliant, they know exactly what they're talking about. So I think there's a lot that this place offers and I can take from them.
Yeah. So you're a hostelite?
Yes, I am.
Your take on that, hostel life?
Hostel life, I didn't know how it would be. I've never been away from home. Maximum for a week or so, but that must have been like excursions, and I always knew I'm coming back home. Hostel life has been great so far, with the fact that it's only been a week and I haven't missed home so much. The wardens are so sweet that I don't really miss my mother too much. Actually, you know, they're really sweet, and they let you do things that you want to do, and you know, there is quite amount of liberty that's given to you to do your things. and responsibility comes along with it, and the fact that you're living by yourself, it gives you that kind of independence, you know, it gives you that kind of courage that okay, you have to move out, you will manage on your own. The friends have been wonderful. I never imagined I would be friends with so many people from different parts of the country. I think I can brag about it to my friends back home, saying, you know, I have friends from each and every state of India. So that way it's been just amazing, and they're so friendly. It's like, it doesn't feel like you're new to them. They're just themselves. I'm being myself. We don't have to put on a face to, you know, mingle around or anything. So that way I think it's just good. I didn't even realize how a week has just gone by, and all of us, just last night we were wondering how fast time is going, and we wouldn't realize how these 2 years are going to go.
Yeah. Thank you so much for being with us, Anusha.
Emphasis is
alive. I have someone with me here today who himself hails from Nepal. Hi Rahul, and welcome to the Candid Gardenian. Where in Nepal are you from?
I'm from Kathmandu, capital only.
Why choose Garden City College for your graduation?
As I had prepared my plus two. So I was just sitting along. I talked with my father, and he told me, okay, go to Bangalore. Just make a round. I came over here, I went to different colleges. So at that time, they told me that after 3 months, 4 months admission, I came to Garden City College. First, trust office told me, visit the college, have the food, hostel facility, then come. And then I visited all the college. The teachers were really good. Like some of attendants, they came in and saw me hold the classes, rooms and everything. I went over to the hostel, looked the rooms, and had my lunch over there also. And then came over here, and then it was really good. My experience was, because in my time, like a bachelor's degree, like this kind of teachers, I won't get anywhere. I did my enrollment and all before only. From Nepal only, I was talking with the teachers through internet and all. Because I was really happy I was in Garden City College.
Which course are you pursuing?
I'm personally in BCA.
You know, over this 1 year that you have spent in Garden City College, what are the different kind of things that you've done?
Like, our college have, in studies, it's good. As well as in studies, our college is good for culturals. And like, after coming here, I learned Chinese a little bit.
Okay.
The guys are really good. And Saudi guys are there. Africans guys.
So you're asking students to utilize all the opportunities that they get in Garden City College and to make the most of it.
All this stuff, because later on they won't get this
platform. Such opportunities.
School life's a platform, but college life you won't get platforms like this.
All right, thank you so much, Rahul. It's been an absolute pleasure having you on the show. Having spoken to Rahul Khiraya from Nepal, he says it is the ambience here in Garden City College which makes a student feel at home. In a nutshell, Garden City College for international students is but a home away from home.
Emphasis is alive.
Here we have someone who is Mr. Popular on campus. Here we have someone who is very well known for his emceeing skills. We have Mr. Sonu Somraj with us. Hello, Sonu. Why did you choose Garden City College for your graduation?
It's really great to be in such a campus because, you know, life back at home alone or somewhere in another country without going to college, it was really murky. So when the campus is like a muse for a mural, like really like an art, the way the campus has been built. I love it.
Alright, what do you have to say about the confluence of cultures in Garden City College?
It's a diversity of culture, I can tell you. And when I came to this this college, I couldn't miss my place, my college back in Australia. I studied in Queen's College. I never missed it because I found the same situation here. People from Africa, we had people from Iran. It's all mingling with them, having fun with them. It's all the same here.
You have been a part of, you know, fresherism. How was it like being a participant, having, you know, done the kind of things that the participants are required to do? How was it like, the experience altogether?
Right from my childhood, I've been on stages, but, you know, I would do only one. Either emceeing for a show, as in anchoring, or organizing the show. But fresherism was one thing where we had to exhibit ourselves in every walk of life. It's like we had the army camp. We had dance. I never used to sing. I'm not even a bathroom singer. I had to sing for fresherism.
Okay.
That's where I experienced everything. I had to show up myself.
What have you chosen as your, you know, the course of study?
I'm doing my BBM in Garden City College. Second year. It's my second year.
How do you think Garden City College can aid you in becoming who you are?
As in, this college has been something which helped me exhibit everything I have in myself. you know, maybe at school I was only MCing or I was doing my group discussion, but this college is something, you know, I've experienced everything. I can tell you this college has nurtured in me something new too. How to manage people, and that's what I don't do all the time. It's very difficult for me to manage people because usually I think about myself, I'm very selfish. I think about myself, I do things my way. But then when it came to this college, handling activities, organizing things, I have to think what other people want me to do. That's what this college has developed in me. And talking about the career part, my course, BBM is one course I found in other colleges. We always have to sit in class, study, but this college, I didn't find that in my class. We could do our studies at home and then come back with works. We moreover have homeworks, like assignments. We don't have a class study, we have case studies. We go to the real scenario, and when it comes to my course, business, I didn't find any teachers asking me what is economics according to Adam Smith. They've always asked me what is economics according to you, and that's what I like about this college. They don't expect us to be like always in class and studying. All they want to give, we need to give our best.
So there's a lot of learning beyond classroom here.
Yes, there's a lot of learning.
It was an absolute pleasure having you on the talk show. Well, Sonu says, no matter whatever thing you do, big or small, you should always put in your best. And that is what takes a person to the heights of success. Well, great thought it is. As for me, it's time I leave. Maybe I should go catch up on a cup of coffee and a nice book to read. As for you guys, have a nice time. Signing off with the Candid Gardenian, this is Reniki. Thank you.